Alright, this is just gonna be me speed running through the kinematic sheet. I'm not gonna explain anything, I'm just gonna work through it. I might comment a little bit here and there, but for the most part, I'm not gonna say anything. I'm just gonna speed solve it so you can kinda follow through what I do. And that is the answer. D is the answer. You get a negative number here, which is fine, but they only want the magnitude of the car's acceleration, so they just want the number. So the answer is A. Number three. All right, so this problem, I should have erased that. So there are two ways to solve this problem. Easiest way is to use this formula. It doesn't have acceleration. We know that v bar is f, vf plus vi over 2 dt. Because that's how you calculate the average of velocity. Again, that's what this is, average velocity or speed. To calculate average, I'm gonna add two numbers and then divide them by 2. And times 12 on both sides. That's how you get it. The second method, and that was the first method, that was the easiest method. The second method is figure out what A is first, right? So we figure out what A is first. So now we know what A is. 0.5 meters per second squared. And now we can solve for D. Let's do this. Fifteen times 10 is 150, times 2 more times 180. 12 for 144 times divided by 4 is, I'm dividing by 4 because 1 half times 0.5 is 0.25, that's 1/4. And so 144, 12 squared is 144. 144 divided by 4 is 36. Just so you know where I'm getting that from. Alright, we get 260 meters. So we get 260 in both situations. Either way works. Doesn't matter as long as you get the answer. Number 4. As it has 2.5 meters per second squared. If you didn't quite see that, please just pause and maybe slow down the YouTube video. Or rewind and pause somewhere. So the answer is A for number 4. The answer is A. I mean, it's less than 2, so it has to be A. It's alright. So you just round it, so you get this answer and then you round it to A. So yeah, it's A 1.9. Should be somewhere around a number. Oh, it should not be a 9, that should be an 8. So it is 3. I mean, it is D, not 3. So number 8. So you didn't see anything. I was wondering what that was. this is A and this is sorry, I'm prone to mistakes. I wasn't reading. This is the final. So it's going to be B. Yep. See that my handwriting has gone from poor to worse. Answer is A. Same thing here, you're missing A, so we can solve it without A, we can use this formula. Again, average V, you're adding up both velocities and then you're dividing it by 2. It's going to be 12. That's gonna be, since you have 120, well, in scientific notation, that's 1.2 times 10 to the 2 meters. Because 10 to the 2, you have two decimal places, two zeros, 11. So you're going to see a negative here, negative 3 meters per second squared, I mean negative 3.5. So basically what the negative means, just means it's the opposite of the positive direction. In the problem, the positive direction is west. So in the negative direction, it's going to be east, so the answer is going to be A. Something I've noticed that all the answers have always been, most of the answers have been A for some reason. Don't know why. I think about it, I probably do know why. 240.4. It's gonna be. Can't do that in my head. I don't have a shortcut in my head for that, for decimals. And so 12 would be 16, so that'd be C. Hundred times 500 times a half 250. And the answer is C. Not sure if you hear all the background noises with all the planes and the cars, but feel free to mute anytime. Well, it's too late now. What's 144 times 3? Oh, it's 42. So the answer is going to be C. Because you're just rounding it. Alright. That is the video.